I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this episode, we're going to take a quick look at how you can use dynamic trimming to actually execute trim operations while your program is playing. Now, there are two ways you can do this. So-called quick trim is the fastest, hence the name. Simply hold the command key down and then use J or L to play in whatever direction you want at whatever speed you want, either regular speed or one of the fast forward modes, and then press K to stop. And you're able to play through the timeline and trim at the same time. The limitation of quick trim mode is you can't trim in slow motion and you can't trim frame by frame using all of the modes that JKL gives you. So what you need to do is press the W key if you want to enter the full dynamic trim mode. You'll see this text appears here in your toolbar to remind you of what it is you're doing. And at this point, you now have the option of trimming at normal speed, or you can hold the K key down and press J or L to trim in slow motion, forward, in slow motion, backward, or frame by frame by tapping. So this is a really flexible way of trimming. So for example, if I wanted to select this roll edit and then command click this other roll edit, I can now use dynamic trimming to trim these all at the same time. While I'm trimming, you can hear audio playback happening, and I can even, in the case of having multiple selections, use the left and right arrow keys to choose which edit I want to monitor while I'm trimming. I can jump from edit to edit as I refine this trim operation. And all of this, of course, also works with the nudge keys and all of the other methods I have available to me for trimming. Whenever I'm done dynamically trimming, I want to make sure I exit the mode so that the JKL keys go back to controlling the playhead instead of doing trimming. And I simply do that by pressing W again to exit trim mode. And that's really all there is to it. Hope you like that. If you want more information about how to use DaVinci Resolve, I strongly recommend you check out my other titles for Ripple Training, which now includes what's new in DaVinci Resolve 12, and soon to include editing in DaVinci Resolve 12. Thanks a lot for watching.